The latest figures from the Uganda Bureau of Statistics indicates that inflation is now down to about 7.6 from 8.4 that was in December 2015. Certainly, this is a beautiful thing. And despite speculations from the market, you know, market analysts and whatnot, the Bureau says this is steady. And the money that the campaign, you know, people are putting in the market won't have a great impact. But that will be coming in next week as we shall be explaining what that means moving forward. Hello there, thank you very much for joining us on Money Trail. My name is Simon Oktela and we are here at the Sheraton Kampala Hotel trying to discuss what is making headlines in the world of business. But first, let's take a look at what you can expect on the show tonight. Coming up on the show, we tell you about 225 standards that have been passed. In a discussion this week, we look at the Commercial Bank of Africa and why they think transfer of money should be on mobile money and not visiting the branches.
First of all, I'll give you a presentation how it works. And then thereafter, we go to the real business.
And in this week's Personal Finance, we look at the basic tips from the January blues and how February could step in. These and more coming up in just a bit. Welcome to the show, and we'll start with the Commercial Bank of Africa from Kenya, which has opened shop in Uganda. Now, this brings the number of commercial banks to about 30 in Uganda. Of course, the competition, yes, is set, but now this particular bank is coming with a platform, a mobile money platform, that will allow people to take loans online. How will this work? Take a look. With technology evolving rapidly and platforms adopting them for easy service delivery, Ugandan small and medium borrowers will soon be able to skip the hassle of filing documents and declaring property in quest of accessing a loan from the banks to grow their businesses. According to a Kenyan-owned bank and a new player in the market, a platform dubbed Neshwari Money Transfer will enable people get quick capital injections of up to 1.5 million shillings via mobile money transactions. The platform, which cuts the cost of operating a bank branch by over 60%, has been successful in Kenya and is now entering the Uganda market.
Before the end of this quarter, we shall have made a stride, or even we shall have gotten a due date within which to launch that product.
As Commercial Bank of Africa joins the market with a focus on growing small and medium businesses through easing loan acquisitions, top managers say collateral should not be a basis on which to offer loan. With a new platform, Neshwari Money Transfer, which market analysts say could grow the industry, the borrower will receive money without traveling to the main branch. Already, the bank has sealed a deal with MTN Uganda, allowing a customer to take up to 1.5 million shillings loan depending on their history of debt repayment.
I'm waiting for the Bank of Uganda's approval, MTN, to start with. And I'll be calling you to this table or somewhere else. And then I'll be able to give you, first of all, I'll give you a presentation how it works.
Odeke says, although banks have adopted innovations provided by technology, micro-saving and lending remains a virgin area to be exploited. On the aspect of risk assessment, the bank will work with the Credit Reference Services Bureau to track the record of borrowers.
When we are appraising you, giving you a loan, on the core accounting system, we have Credit Reference Bureau. Before you open an account, they put you on the take your picture, what, put your fingers on. So you're already captured on the credit reference bureau. Now, on this other product that we mentioned, the micro lending and credit, even that one will be captured on the credit reference bureau. The information that comes from, because these people will definitely have an account in the banking system.
So the Commercial Bank of Africa is in Uganda, of course, now bring the numbers to over about 28 commercial banks here. And of course, it's introducing a product, a micro saving and loans product, which means that money will be sent to people through mobile money. That if you're taking a loan from the bank, you know, you do not have to walk to the bank. You can get it through your phone. But helping me, you know, discuss that and more is Eddie, who's a business reporter at The New Vision. Thank you for joining us on the show.
You're welcome.
Have you been?
I'm okay.
All right. That product from Commercial Bank of Africa, what do you make of it?
Well, in my opinion, it's a very good product because we have so many people who are not banked. As you know, statistics put the number of bank accounts in the country at about 5 million, which is very, very, very small. Now, this product can help in two ways. One, it can help to increase the number of bank accounts that we have in the country, therefore increasing financial inclusion in the country. Because, for example, that product by the Commercial Bank of Africa is driving itself on the MTN platform, which already has about 8 million customers. Now, if you have 8 million customers all seeking to have something to do with this product, with this micro loan, you already have 8 million additional bank accounts to what we already have. Because one of the requirements is that they must have, the customers who need the loan, must have a standard bank account. Standard bank account procedures must be followed for the account to be opened before the money is posted on the customer's account.
So let's talk about the safety of this. You know, looking at the fact that the bank has to send money on through your phone, the trust bit of it, where do we see it really?
The bank that is advancing a loan to you does not know you, but they're looking at your history, your relationship with your mobile network, MTN. How do you buy Airtel? How do you pay your debts on the network? Because many people borrow airtime in times of emergency and payback. How long does it take you to pay back that airtime? Or what's your phone user habits? It is just that relationship that they will be banking on. And because safety is not a very serious guarantee here.
Let's talk about the success stories in Kenya. Safaricom. There's that platform, what is it called?
Mshwari,
yes. In Kenya, big thing?
In Kenya, Mshwari is quite successful. In fact, like the default rate in Kenya is actually only 5%, which is way below the industry standard because the default rate in conventional banks is quite much higher than the 5% that Mshwari has registered in Kenya. So it is quite successful. In Kenya, Mshwari has over 27 million customers using that mobile loan and credit scheme. So Kenya has been quite successful. More people are taking up these loans, and they're very effective. They're very effective. So Kenya is okay.
The central bank has a role here. Do you think they'll pass this soon, allow it to come to the market?
I think so. I think so, because it's a good thing for the banking industry here. Given the fact that over the so many years, more than 10 years, the central bank has been fighting for financial inclusion. It has started campaigns for financial inclusion, and it hasn't been so successful until this opportunity presented itself. So if you're looking at adding 8 million customers on the banking platform, and it is not only limited to that, because we have about 19 million mobile phone users in this country, 19 to 23 million. I'm not sure of the statistic there, but it's between 19 and 23 million. Now, if you have an opportunity of even adding just 10 million people with bank accounts, it means that's huge success for financial inclusion. So I don't see the Bank of Uganda refusing to approve this product. It's one in a million.
Oh, thank you very much for making time and putting up a couple of things really clear out there.
Oh, thanks.
All the best. Well, Edward Kayua there. He is a business reporter with The New Vision, trying to explain this product from the Commercial Bank of Africa. Of course, just, you know, there are about 6 million account holders in Uganda. Really way below that. Over 20 million, you know, subscribers on the mobile money platform. If this comes in, we can expect that more people will get on the banking section or, you know, have more accounts. And financial literacy plans by the central bank will certainly work, because this is a great thing for Uganda and the region moving forward. When I take a very short break, when I return, I'll be telling you about 225 standards that have been passed by the National Standards Council. We'll be right back.